Hey guys, and thanks for watching my tutorial series on how to make a game like Valorant. This is just part one of a multi-part series. But don't worry, we're going to go as far as we can over these next couple videos to get a playable mini version of the game. First things first, when you want to make your Unity 3D game beautiful, you got to use Universal Render Pipeline. It really makes a difference. It adds custom shaders, and it turns your games from this to this. If you guys like this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and if you want to continue to follow along with my game dev journey, hit that subscribe button. So to get started, I'm going to make a plane. This is going to be the floor to set up our character movement. Next, I'll make an empty game object and name it player. And then I'll make a cylinder as its child. The cylinder is going to be our placeholder character while we set up movement. Next, we're going to add the character controller onto the player, not the cylinder. Otherwise, we'll mess everything up. It'd be like if your arms moved independently of your head and tore themselves off. Not a pretty sight. We also have to remove the default capsule collider from the cylinder, since the character controller actually comes with its own capsule collider. Next, we're going to make a micro environment. So I'm going to add these ramps. That's going to help us test the gravity that we're going to create around the end of the video. Don't make him too high. You're not trying to kill the cylinder. Make him just high enough where he won't break his legs. Next, we're going to make the main camera a child of our player. So this will create the first person effect. You can zero it out and move it up towards his head. Now we're going to make two separate movement scripts, and this is just to make sure the code is readable with individualized class functions. The character movement scripts are actually pulled almost exactly from a Brackeys tutorial. I'll link it in the description. And if I'm not explaining this stuff well enough, he definitely will. Okay, so first let's edit the camera movement script to create a smooth movement when you move the mouse. In the update section of the script, we're going to create a float called mouseX and have it equal to input.getAxis mouseX. And the same for mouseY. These are Unity defaults for mouse input on the X and Y axes. Basically left and right and up and down. Alright, and then we'll create a serialized private float for mouse sensitivity. Let's give it a value of 100. Now in order to create smooth movement, multiply both mouseX and mouseY by mouse sensitivity and time.deltaTime. Time.deltaTime is an adjusted number which calculates time based on the client-side frame rate. Alright, so now we're going to create a serialized private transform, and that'll hold our player object. We're doing this because when we move the mouse left and right, we want the actual character to move left and right. Now rotate the player body over the y-axis, which is vector 3 dot up, and we're going to multiply that by mouse y. Save it and let's test this out. Oops, something's not right. It's not working. Classic game dev, folks. I move the mouse up and down and he looks left and right. So the problem actually lies in the input. Mouse X is supposed to be left and right, but I put mouse Y. At least we know it. It's an easy fix. Alright, so now let's do the up and down rotation. We're going to have to do stuff a little bit differently because we don't want to be able to look all the way around 360 degrees. It just wouldn't be right. Alright, so to declare a private float X rotation, we're going to set it equal to 0. In the update function, subtract mouse Y from X rotation, and we're going to use the mathf clamp function to set the bounds of the rotation. Subtracting X rotation from mouse input gives us a negative number and a new variable to use. We're going to subtract because if you add, it actually inverts the controls, and when you push the mouse down, it looks up, so we want them normal, so we're going to use a negative number. Alright, now let's take the X rotation value and rotate our camera with transform.localRotation. Don't make the same mistake as me though. Transform.localRotation takes quaternion angles and not vector 3. They're similar, but Euler angles actually are specific to rotation, and the function translates these XYZ coordinates to W, X, Y, and Z. Pretty complex stuff. And now let's test. And there we go. We can look up, down, left, and right. Let's just go back into that script and lock the cursor so it doesn't drag across the entire screen. And just to add the final touches, we're gonna take the whole method we wrote in the update function and pop it in its own method, look around. This just keeps the main update function clean and easily identifiable. Now back in Unity, attach the player controller script to the player object, and let's open that in Visual Studio. To start off, we're going to work an update to test it and move things into their own method when we're done. First, let's make a float called horizontal, taking our horizontal input. For the PC, that's the A and D keys. And then we're going to make a float called vertical, which will take our W and S keys. And now let's make a vector 3 called move. We're going to put our horizontal variable in X, Y is 0, and Z will be vertical. I know it's counterintuitive, but the Y-axis in 3D space actually moves up while the Z is forward. But for our purposes, we're going to try and keep everything smooth and actually have the movement rotate with the camera. We're going to switch this up to transform.right times horizontal plus transform.forward times vertical. Now let's attach the character controller to the script. You can either serialize the field, which will allow you to drag the controller from your character into the script, or you can hard code it in and instantiate it with getComponent in the awake method. Both ways are identical. In the update method, we're going to add a controller.move method. Move is our vector 3 times a float called move speed times a time.delta time. Let's set move speed to 10. And now let's test our character. Here we go. We can move up around and climb the ramps. We're finally handy capable. One problem is that since we're not using rigid body, we won't fall. We're going to have to create our own gravity. First, let's put the movement script in its own method, movement. Now we're going to make a serialized float called gravity, and we're going to set it equal to negative 10. The real value for gravity is 9.81, but I just rounded up, and it's negative because it's a downward force. Next, create a vector 3 for our velocity. It's going to be the variable for how fast we fall. And we're going to subtract gravity times time.delta time from the y value of velocity, and then make the character actually move that amount times time.delta time. When you're calculating gravity, the formula involves time squared. You could just as easily write it like this, but it definitely looks more balanced when it's on each value. Just know as long as you have time squared, it'll be right. All right, and let's just pop all this into its own gravity method. Make sure you put gravity above movement in the update function. All right, and let's just test. And there we go. We fall successfully to the ground. Next thing we need is a capability to jump. So first we have to add a Boolean variable to check if we're grounded. And in our movement method, we're gonna add an if statement for jumping. If get button down jump and is grounded, which will stop double jumping, we'll add some force to our y velocity. I'm using a physics equation that Brackeys provided, which involves taking the square root of the jump force times negative 2 times gravity. This should provide a smooth arc for our character's jump. Now in order to check if is grounded is true or false, we're gonna use check sphere method in Unity's physics utility. For that, we need to create a float called ground distance, a transform for an object ground check, and a layer mask to select the ground layer. Make sure all these are serialized. Also, make sure to set ground distance above 0. In the gravity method, we're going to use another statement to ensure that we fall smoothly from a jump. If we're grounded and our velocity is 0, then we'll set a negative velocity as a safeguard. Now go back to Unity, let's create a ground check object as a child of the player object. Make sure to move it toward the feet area. Alright, and let's add a ground layer. Then we'll group all of our ground objects into one game object, and set the layer of that parent to ground, and apply to all children. Next, we're going to drag the ground check object into the transform field and set the layer mask to ground. And there we go, now we can jump. Now let's go grab a beautiful character to replace our cylinder. I'm going to use Mixamo, which uses the Adobe Creative Cloud subscription. If you don't already subscribe, I would. I use many of their programs when it comes to creating games or content related to games. Mixamo's great, because they have a good amount of commercial use characters. They also have a wide array of animations. I'm going to pick the dummy for this. In order to get a textured character imported from Mixamo to Unity, it's a two-step process. First, we're going to download the Collada file. Next, create a Mixamo file in your Unity Assets folder, and open the Collada.rar and take the textures from it. After that, we're going to download the FBX for Unity file, and save all that into a new Mixamo character folder we just created. Alright, go back to Unity, click Fix Now, and let's make this prefab a child of our player object. Line it up with the cylinder, and delete the cylinder. I'm moving the camera to match the head of the new man I got. And there we go, we're all set up. Alright, this is going to be it for part 1. I hope it was easy to follow, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please like the video and subscribe. The next part's going to be coming out in the coming weeks. Thanks, bye.